Hello!
Hi!
Welcome to Virtual Storytime!
Yeah, today it's a party! A party!
It is! We're talking all about parties today, so we hope that you enjoy all of our party stories and a party puppet show, and we'll see you after that. Bye!
I'm going to read you Dragons Love Tacos, and you might be thinking, what does that have to do with parties? Well, they do indeed have a taco party, which is just one of the many kinds of parties that you could have. So let's read about it. Hey kid, did you know that dragons love tacos? They love beef tacos and chicken tacos. They really love big, gigantic tacos and tiny little baby tacos as well. Why do dragons love tacos? Maybe it's the smell from the sizzling pan. Maybe it's the crunch of the crispy tortillas. Maybe it's a secret. Either way, if you want to make friends with dragons, tacos are key. Hey dragon, why do you guys love tacos so much? But wait, as much as dragons love tacos, they hate spicy salsa even more. They hate spicy green salsa and spicy red salsa. They hate spicy chunky salsa and spicy smooth salsa. If the salsa is spicy at all, dragons can't stand it. Why do dragons hate spicy salsa? Well, just one drop of hot sauce makes a dragon's ears smoke. Just one single speck of hot pepper makes a dragon snort sparks. Spicy salsa gives dragons tummy troubles. And when dragons get tummy troubles, oh boy. If you want to make tacos for dragons, keep the toppings mild. Tomatoes, lettuce, cheese. These are all good toppings for dragons on tacos. Hey dragon, how do you feel about spicy taco toppings? Dragons love parties. They like costume parties and pool parties. They like big, gigantic parties with accordions and little tiny parties with charades. Why do dragons love parties? Maybe it's the conversation. Maybe it's the dancing. Maybe it's the comforting sound of a good friend's laughter. All very good reasons. The only thing dragons love more than parties or tacos is, you guessed it, taco parties. Taco parties are parties with lots of tacos. If you want to have some dragons over for a taco party, you'll need buckets of tacos, pant loads of tacos. The best way to judge is to get a boat and fill the boat with tacos. That's about how many tacos dragons need for a taco party. After all, dragons love tacos. Hey dragon, are you excited for the big taco party? I think they are. They wrote it on the calendar. Just remember, dragons hate spicy salsa. Before you host your taco party with dragons, get rid of all the spicy salsa. In fact, bury the spicy salsa in the backyard so the dragons can't find it. These dragons love your taco party. They love the music, they love the decorations. They especially love the tacos. Congratulations. Looks like everyone is having a great time at your taco party. It's a good thing you got rid of all that spicy. Wait a second. Are those little green things in the salsa? Are they peppers? You didn't read the fine print. Oh no, now with spicy jalapeno peppers. What do you think is gonna happen? Dragons, listen to me. Do not eat those tacos. Those little green specks in the salsa, they're jalapeno peppers. They are super spicy. I know you love tacos, dragons, but you are not gonna love those tacos. Do not let those dragons eat those tacos. Crunch, crunch, crunch. Oh. Oh my gosh, look at all those flames. I think that the jalapeno peppers were too spicy. It's too late. They burned the whole party down. Oh my goodness. Why would dragons help you rebuild your house? Maybe they're good Samaritans. Maybe they feel bad for wrecking it. Maybe they're just in it for the taco breaks. After all, dragons love tacos. The end.
And I'm going to read you a story called If You Give a Pig a Party. Let's find out. If you give a pig a party, she's going to ask for some balloons. When you give her the balloons, she'll want to decorate the house. When she's finished, she'll put on her favorite dress. Then she'll call all her friends to invite them to the party. Her friends won't be home, so you'll have to go with her to look for them. On the way, she'll see a street fair. She'll want you to take her on the bumper cars. All her friends will be there. There they all are. Then you'll have to take her on all the rides. She'll want to play all the games too. This looks like a really fun fair. When she's done, she'll ask you for some ice cream. Yum. When she's finished eating her ice cream, she'll need to change her clothes. You'll have to take her home. She'll ask her friends to come along. On the way, she'll start a game of hide and seek. Uh-oh, look, where are they all hiding? Can you see them all? When you finally get home, you'll have to make dinner. Then she'll want to have a sleepover. You'll have to find pajamas and blankets and pillows for everyone. When she sees the pillows, she'll probably start a, what do you think? A pillow fight, of course. Then she'll make a fortress out of blankets. Of course, when she's finished, she'll want to decorate it. So she'll ask for some balloons. And chances are, if you give her some balloons, she's going to ask you for a party. The end.
Mouse found a deserted house and decided to make his home there. But it was a very big house for such a small mouse, and he felt a little lonely. I know, he thought, I'll have a party. So he sent invitations to all his friends.
The first to arrive were Cat with a mat and Dog with a log.
Then came Hare with a chair, an owl with a towel.
Next up were Giraffe with a bath, and Hen with a pen.
Followed by Lamb with some jam, and Rat with bat in a hat.
Last but not least came Fox with a box, full of lots and lots of different kinds and colors of socks. Let's party, said Mouse. But
rat-a-tat-tat-tat-tat.
It was Elephant with two trunks. He was blowing through one and carrying the other.
Hello, said Mouse. Welcome to my house.
Your house? Said Elephant, and he looked quite angry. I've just been away on a long vacation. This house, I must tell you, is mine.
Oh, said Mouse, Lamb, Hare, Rat, and Bat.
Oh, said Hen, Dog, Owl, Fox, and Giraffe.
But come in, said the cat. You're just in time for the party.
A party? For me? Said Elephant. Oh my, yippee.
So they ate and they drank and they danced until late and had the most marvelous party.
And later, when the guests had all gone home, leaving Elephant and Mouse alone, Elephant said,
I think, little mouse, perhaps it's true. There's room for both of us in this house, don't you?
The end.
Hi, and welcome back. I hope you enjoyed those fun party stories that we read you.
And we have a really great craft for you this week as well. So you can come to the library and pick that up, the supplies that you need, or you can call us from the parking lot. We'll bring it out to you. And Mrs. Cammie will have an instruction video up tomorrow. So have a great week. Enjoy. And we will see you next time on Virtual Storytime.
Bye.